Good morning, students. I am Sarika Hitesh Pawar, teacher here from Daudbag English UPS School. Today we are going to learn subject play, do and learn. So students, tell me now, what more do you need to stay fit? What more do you need to stay fit? What you will do? Tell me, raise your hands up. Vihan, what you will do being fit and fine?
Exercise.
Yes, exercise you will do. Very good. Balanced diet and exercise. Both things are very much important to us. Right? So, exercise you will do. Na? So, there are different kinds of exercises are there. So, today we are going to learn about exercise. Lesson number 5. Exercise. In that lesson, parts are there. 5.1 Surya Namaskar and 5.2 different body postures. So first of all, we will complete 5.1. So let us go towards 5.1 Surya Namaskar. Do you know about Surya Namaskar? Do you know about Surya Namaskar?
Yes.
Yes. You heard about it, na? So today we will learn about Surya Namaskar. It's different steps of it, and each steps has a different yogasana name. So that name also I will tell you, how to do it, that also I will tell you, and benefits of that also I will tell you. So we are going to cover all these points in this lesson. So be careful about it. So first of all, we will learn about, there are 10 steps in that. Okay, your textbook page number is 28. If you have your textbook, play, do and learn, open it and your page number is 28. So let us learn towards lesson number 5, exercises, and 5. Its first point, sub point is 5.1, that is Surya Namaskar. Then see here, first step number 1, step number 2, step number 3, step number 4, step number 5, step number 6, step number 7, step number 8, step number 9, and step number 10. There are totally 10 steps are there. Okay? You got it about it? First of all, Surya Namaskar has 10 steps are given. So here, see your first step. I will explain the names of each position. And each position is a different yogasans are there. That names also I am going to tell you. First is Urdhva Hastasana. What is the name of the first asana? Urdhva Hastasana. Here we also call it as a raise arm pose. That yogasana also we will call it as a raise arm pose position. Okay. Second one, see here, Hastapadasana. Second position is known as Hastapadasana. Hand to foot pose is mentioned here. Hand to foot position shown here in step number 2. Now see here, step number 3. Ashva Sanchalan Asana. I wrote name here, so you can also write it by, you can also write it by pencil. So write it here under this position, Ashva Sanchalan Asana. Okay. And position number 4, Dandasana. Position number 5, Ashtanga Namaskar. Position number 5 is Ashtanga Namaskar. See here, position number 6, Bhujangasana. Position number 6, Bhujangasana. That is also called as Cobra pose. Bhujanga means snake. So this position also called it as a Cobra pose. Next one is 7. Which is the 7th pose? Parvatasana. Parvatasana. Parvat means mountain. So this position also called as a mountain pose. Okay. This looks as like a cobra, like snake, So it is called as a Bhujangasana. Okay. Here it is like mountain shape. So we call it as a mountain pose or Parvatasana. Got it, all of you? Very simple to remember. Next one is Ashva Sanchalan Asana. See here, position number 3 and position number 8 are same are there. See the both the position. Both the positions are same. And position number 2 and position number 9 also same. Hastapadasana. Okay. Second position and ninth position also same. Why it is same? Because when we are performing the Surya Namaskar stepwise, then again we have to come back in the same position. So last position is Pranam Asana. We have to stand in Pranam Asana and we have to end the Surya Namaskar in Pranam Asana only. So start it from Pranam Asana and end it here up to the Pranam Asana. So position number, again I am explaining you, position number 1 is Urdhva Hastasana, position number 2 is Hastapadasana, position number 3 Ashva Sanchalan Asana, position number 4 Dandasana, position number 5 Ashva Sanchalan Asana, position number 6 Bhujangasana, position number 7 Parvatasana, position number 8 Ashva Sanchalan Asana, position number 9 Hastapadasana, and position number 10 is Pranam Asana. Got it, all of you? This page number is on 28. You have to observe in this page, and also you have to write the names of each position that I wrote here. You can also write the names below the picture of it. By pencil you have to write. Now see here, one by one I will explain the each asana. So first one is, what is the first one? Tell me the name. I just now I told you all the names of the, all the 10 steps names I told you just now. You have to tell me the position number 1. Who will tell me the position number 1? Step number 1, who will tell me? Tell me, raise your hands up. Anybody wants to tell me the position, name of the position 1, that is step number 1 of the Surya Namaskar? Yes, I will tell you. Urdhva Hastasana. Position number 1 is Urdhva Hastasana. So here, step to perform Urdhva Hastasana, upward salute. What we do? Upward salute we have to do. Stand with your feet together. Stand with your feet together. Press the sole of your feet down into the floor. You have to press your sole of your feet down into the floor. Place your hands in first of all namaste position. Then you have to raise your hands up. Upward direction here, and you have to bend in the backward direction. Okay, keeping your palms together in raised hand, arms up towards the sky until your arms are straight. What you have to do? Keeping your palms together, raise your hand, arms up towards the sky until your arms are straight. This position should be in straight position. Just you have to bend little bit backward side. Alternatively, you can stretch your arms upward, keeping them parallel with your palms facing each other. You can keep your head in a neutral position, looking straight ahead. Just have to keep your head also constant position and don't move. Just be in that position only. That position is a Urdhva Hastasana. And keep in mind, while doing the Surya Namaskar, just you have to put yoga mat, otherwise one mat or one simply plain cloth, and your surrounding should be clean and neat, and ventilation should be proper, airy. That all these things you have to keep in mind. Second one is, wait, I will tell the Urdhva Hastasana benefit also. हस्तासना बेनिफिट्स. सूर्य नमस्कार स्टेप नंबर वन ऊर्ध्व हस्तासना बेनिफिट्स. ऊर्ध्व हस्तासना स्ट्रेचेस द साइड्स ऑफ द बॉडी स्पाइन शोल्डर एंड आर्मपिट्स एंड बेली. दैट इज द बेनिफिट. व्हाट द ऊर्ध्व हस्तासना डज. ऊर्ध्व हस्तासना स्ट्रेचेस द साइड ऑफ द बॉडी स्पाइन शोल्डर्स आर्मपिट एंड बेली. It tones the thigh, improves digestion, and helps to relieve anxiety and fatigue. It also helps to create space in the chest and lung, which is therapeutic for asthma and congestion. That is, for the asthma and for the congestion, it's work like a therapy. Okay, Urdhva Hastana. All these are the benefits of Urdhva Hastana benefits. Surya Namaskar, step number one. Now let us move towards Surya Namaskar, step number two. That is Hasta Padasana. What is Hasta Padasana, step number two? Now see here. Stand straight with an erect spine. What you have to do? Stand straight in a erect spine. Both the legs should be touching each other. Your both legs should be touched to each other. Now, take a deep breath. That is inhalation you have to do. And bring your both the hands above your head. Hand should be straight. What you have to do? Hand should be straight. Then, now breathing out. That is, you have to do exhalation. First of all, you have to do inhalation. After that, you have to do the exhaling. Bend forward from your waist and try to touch your feet with both the hands. What you have to do? Just you have to bend downside and you have to exhale it and try to touch your feet with the both the hands. Both the hands you have to touch to your feet. Do not bend your knees. These knees should not be bent. Your knees should not be bent. Keep in mind, your head should be in contact with the knees. Your head should be in contact with the knees. Means your head should be touched to the knees. This position should be in straight position. Don't bend your knees. Okay. Next. Hold this position for few seconds and breathe normally. Just we have to be in that position for 5 seconds. And normally breathing you have to do. Now while inhaling, come back to the starting position. Then again, you have to come back in a starting position. Repeat this for few times. Like that way, you have to repeat this for few times for performing Hasta Padasana. So here is the position of the Hasta Padasana. And now I will tell you the benefits of Hasta Padasana. See here, position of Hasta Padasana. Effective to increase height, reduce belly fat and gives flat stomach. Cure stomach disorder like constipation. Strengthens the spine and brings flexibility. Stop hair loss problems. Increase blood circulation in the brain. Increase blood circulation in the brain. That is the benefits of Hasta Padasana. Okay. Now see the position number three. What is the position number three? Ashva Sanchalan Asana. So now here I will tell the description about the Ashva Sanchalan Asana. How you have to be in that position. Just listen it carefully. It is also known as equestrian pose in English. What we will call it as a Ashva Sanchalan Asana, also called as equestrian pose. And in Sanskrit, Ashva Sanchalan Asana name is in Sanskrit language. The Sanskrit name Ashva Sanchalana is derived from the three words. That is, Ashva means horse, Sanchalana means movement, and Asana meaning posture. This asana is practiced at the third and eighth position in the Surya Namaskar series. See here, third number, position number third and position number eight. Same, Ashva Sanchalana. Third and eighth position are the same position. So we call it at the third and the eighth position in the Surya Namaskar series. Practicing this asana stimulates abdominal organs. What is doing? Surya Namaskar series. Practicing this asana stimulates abdominal organs. So see here, Ashva Sanchalan we are doing at the step number 3 and also at the step number 8. Okay. Now I will tell you the Ashva Sanchalan asanas benefits. So see here, benefits of the Ashva Sanchalan asanas are step number 3. Strengthens the lower body, builds willpower and determination, stimulates the abdominal organs, strengthens your spine, increases the flexibility of your back, improves your digestion, massage and tones your kidney. All are the benefits of the Ashva Sanchalan asanas. Okay, got it all of you? Please listen it carefully. After that, I will tell you to perform all the yogasana postures. So be in the class, listen it carefully. Ashva Sanchalan asanas benefits I explain here. Keep in mind. If you want, you can also take the screenshot of each and every asanas benefits for your record. Now see here, position number 4, step number 4 is Dandasana. So Dandasana, see here, it's in the position of Dandasana as shown in the picture. So here are some benefits of Dandasana I'm going to tell you. What the Dandasana does? Dandasana does helps to improve posture. What the Dandasana does? Helps improve posture, strengthens back muscle, stretches shoulder and chest, helps to calm brain cells, lengthens and stretches the spine, create body awareness, helps improve alignment of the body. All these are the benefits of the Dandasana, that is Surya Namaskar, step number 4. Okay, now I will explain you the step number 5, Ashtanga Namaskar Asana. What is mean by Ashtanga Namaskar Asana? Ashtanga Namaskar, also called as Ashtanga Dandavat Pranam. 8 limb pose, that is here, 8 body parts touches to the ground, that is called as Ashtanga Namaskar. Ashta means 8, 8 means 8. 8 body parts touches to the ground of the, all the 8 body parts touches to the ground. So this asana is called as Ashtanga Namaskar. It's in position of Namaskara and 8 body organs touches to the ground. That's why you call it as Ashtanga Namaskar. So see here, Ashtanga Namaskar, also called as Ashtanga Dandavat Pranam. 8 limb pose, caterpillar pose or chest, knees and chin pose is a posture sometimes used in the Surya Namaskar sequence in modern yoga as an exercise where the body is balanced on 8 points of contact with the floor, feet, knees, chest and hands, chin and hands. Bhujang, next here, I will explain the Ashtanga Namaskar benefits. See here, benefits of Ashtanga Namaskar. Stretches and strengthens. 8 limb pose. Stretches the toes, soles, hips, lower back and neck. Okay, flexibility and posture. The practice of Ashtanga Namaskar while a balancing pose put pressure on muscles around the spine to hold the body in balance. Okay, to hold the body in balance. You can take the screenshot of the benefits of the Ashtanga Namaskar benefit. This is about the Surya Namaskar step number 5. Keep in mind all of you, after that I will explain. After that I will ask you the position of each and every asana, what the name of that position and what are the benefits. That also I am going to ask you. So listen it carefully. Now see here, position number 6, Bhujangasana. Bhujanga means snake. Bhujanga means snake. Snake matlab saap. That is cobra asana. It is one type of a kind of a snake. That is cobra pose. We will also call it as a cobra pose. Bhujanga asana, also known as cobra position. So see here, Bhujangasana pose, also called as the cobra pose. As Bhujanga means snake, the pose may be entered from a prone position or from downwards dog. The palms are placed under the shoulder. Under the shoulder, you have to place the palms of the hand, pushing down until the hips lift slightly. The back of the feet rest on the ground. The legs outstretched. The gaze is directed towards giving the preparatory pose. So for Bhujangasana, you have to be in that position. Your body should be in proper position. Your feet, both the legs should be touches to the each other, and your head direction, your position of it should be the in the straight position. You have to look in front of yourself. Don't move your head here and there. Okay, be in the straight position. So see here, Bhujangasana benefits, I will explain you. Strengthens the spine, tones the buttocks, stimulates the abdominal organs, helps relieve stress and fatigue, opens the heart and lungs, and therapeutic for asthma. For asthma disease, as a therapy, this asana is very much beneficial, Bhujangasana. Okay, now step number 7, that is Parvatasana. As I already told you, it's like a mountain pose. Parvatasana, parvat means mountain. So this position also called as mountain pose. Straight with the places of your big toes, touching the heels slightly apart so that your second toes are parallel, lift and spread your toes and the balls of your feet, then lay them softly down on the floor. Gradually reduce this swing to the standstill with your weight balance evenly on your feet. So all this weight you have to be handle in your feet and your hand. And your body should be in a straight position. Don't bend your knees, and your head should be in downward direction. Okay, and don't stretch your body, just do it in a relaxed way. This is all about Parvatasana. Like that way, see your benefits of Parvatasanas. Step number 7, Parvatasana. Strengthens to the muscles of the shoulder, arms and legs, increases the flexibility in the spine, hamstring and calves, improves the blood circulation to the brain, tones the spinal nerves and balances the nervous system. Okay, students, these are the benefits of the Parvatasana, that is mountain pose benefits. Step number 7. Now, see here, step number 8. And I already explained you the step number 3 is like the step number 8. And the step number 2, Hastapadasana, and the step number 9, Hastapadasana, are the same. So I already explained the position of these Ashwasanchalanasana as well as Hastapadasana. And also I explained the benefits of Ashwasanchalanasana and the Hastapadasana. Now see last stage, that is the step number 10. Last number is Pranamasana. Now see here, in last step, Pranamasana, we have to be stand in a straight position. See here, stand in a straight position, stand straight, join your hands very nicely, and you have to be in that position. That is Pranamasana. In Namaste position, you have to stand. So Pranamasana, also called as prayer pose, while doing prayer in the school, we all have to be stand in this position. So we also call it as a prayer pose. Just stand straight, join your hands, and keep the distance between your toes, that is 45 angle distance between your toes. Now see here, Pranamasana's benefits. Pranamasana being a standing pose boosts the ability of your legs to sustain more pressure. The practice strengthens the muscles and bones of your legs, and also also augments the joints, knees, ankles, hips, and etc. The health benefits of pranayamasana exceeds to burning the arms muscle and the wrist joints. Okay. The health benefits. Now see here, pranayamasana benefits, I told you here, like that way I told all the benefits of all the asanas. Now just tell me how many steps are there in Surya Namaskar position. Tell me now, how many positions are there? Total how many positions are there? Who will tell me? Raise your hands up. Raise your hands up.
Ten.
Huh? Ten. How many positions are there?
Ten.
Tell me the name of first position. Tell me name of the first position.
Urdu.
Very difficult to pronunciation, lekin no problem. Try to answer. It's okay. Answer. Try to answer. No problem, beta. Urdhva Hastasana. Repeat it after me. Urdhva. Say Urdhva. Hastasana. Very good. Now tell me the position number two. Hastapadasana. Very good. Right. Now see here, position number three. Tell me the position number three. Name of the position number three. Step number three. See, tell me, what is this? A-S-H-W-A. Ashwa. What is?
Ashwa.
Sanchalan. Asan. Ashwa Sanchalan Asan. Very good. Try to answer. No problem. Now, position number four. Difficult names are there. I can understand. But try to answer. Answer. Step number four.
Down.
Dandasana. Very good.
Dandasana.
Now step number five. By position also you have to remember the names of the yogasana. You can also remember by position. Now see here. Here what?
Yogasana.
Here eight body part touches. Now eight means eight. Eight means ashta. In Sanskrit ashta is called. So ashtanga namaskar. What did all of you? By position you have to remember the names. There are some tricks to remember names of the asanas. Now see here, which position I already told you. Now tell me, which position? Which position?
Cobra.
Right. Cobra. Cobra is a one kind of snake. Yes. Cobra. Very good. Cobra is a one kind of snake. So snake in Sanskrit, snake called as bhujang. So it is bhujangasan. Got it all of you? Why it is bhujangasan? Because it's in a cobra pose. Cobra is the one of the snake. And snake, in Sanskrit language, snake called as a bhujanga. So it's asana known as bhujangasana. What did all of you? Now see here. Seven. Now tell me. Which position I already told you. Which position it is?
Ten.
Very good. Means you are listening me very carefully. I thought you are getting bored, but you are not getting bored. You are very attentive in my class. Very good. Now it is which position?
Mountain.
Very good. Mountain. Yes. And in Marathi, mountain called as Parvat, right? And in Sanskrit also called as Parvat. So this this asana is called as Parvatasana. Very good. What did all of you? Why it is called as Parvatasana? Because its shape is like a mountain. Mountain shape is there. So mountain, because in Sanskrit, mountain called as Parvat. So this asana is called as Parvatasana. Very good. I'm so happy for you. Now see here. Step number eight. Ashwa Sanchalan Asana. See here. Step number three and step number eight. Both the steps are same. Okay. Step number three and step number eight. So very easy to remember. Ashwa Sanchalan Asana. Ashwa Sanchalan Asana. Now see here. Step number two. Hastapadasana. And here also, step number nine, Hastapadasana. And last position is Pranamasana. That is, we are doing in Namaste position. Stand in a straight way. Just join your hands very nicely. Stand in a Namaste position. And between your toes, keep 45 degree angle. Okay? And don't move here and there. being, it improve your concentration power. Okay, all of you got this lesson? You understand this lesson?
Yes.
Now here in next lecture, what I will do? In next lecture, I will teach you 5.2 various body postures. This will I will explain in next lecture, and you have to just now note it down your homework. What is your homework? Write down the names of asana. 5 times you have to write, then you can remember it very well. And perform any 2 asanas and click your photos in that yogasana position and send to your class teacher. Got it, all of you? All of you got it, your homework? What I explained? First of all, you have to write the names of the asana 5 times. Then you can easily remember and you can easily pronunciate it well. And second homework is, you have to perform any 2 asana. You have to be in that position, click your photos, and in your WhatsApp group or in your to your class teacher, you have to send it on your WhatsApp, class teacher's WhatsApp. Okay. Thank you, students. Thank you, all of you. Now see here, what you have to do for the upcoming videos, you have to like our channel, BMC Education Standard 1 channel. You have to like it, share it, and subscribe it. Then if you will subscribe it, then you will get the new upcoming videos. And you have to press the bell icon to it. So you will get our upcoming new videos. You will get it. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, students. Thank you, staff.